In, I come into your half body. Exhale, we fold. Step back. And then turn to one side to swivel around into wide legged palms. So just making sure your feet pointing forward, have a bend in your knees. Lengthen your spine forward, lift your sit bones, lift your heart, look forward, and then fold towards your legs. So any shape in your arms, so you can walk your hands through the legs, you can hold on through the shins or hook your index fingers around your big toes. Just do one more forward fold or halfway lift. Inhale, lift your spine halfway, and a little bit more space. And then on your exhale, we fold. Stay here, continue to breathe. Shift your weight into your toes, especially into the balls of your feet. And then root your heels into the earth to lift your sit bones. And then keep a gentle hug from your feet and shins towards the midline. And then keep widening your inner thighs and inner groin back. Keep zipping up the front, the pubic bone to navel, sternum to navel. Breathe into your back. To bend your knees a little bit more, feel free to adjust. Staying here for one more breath. So with your next inhale, walk your hands forward, walk them underneath your shoulders, either with flat hands or fingertips. You're going into a twist, so move your left hand towards your right hand, so right underneath your heart, and take your right arm up towards the sky. Unwind, and then switch hands. Unwind, bring your hands back underneath your shoulders. Take a breath in, lengthen your spine, look forward. Exhale and fold. Inhale, come into half body. Exhale, swivel around to the front and take down. Going into a quadricep stretch, and we're starting off on the floor. So with your next inhale, come forward into plank. Exhale out all the way down onto your belly. Fold your hands underneath your head so you can rest your hands. Rest your head on your hands. So I'd like you to start off with your favorite leg, and now you've got two favorite legs. Bend one knee and catch your foot with the same side hand. Kick your foot into your hand, feel that resistance, and keep pulling your heel towards your hips. Try to keep your knee on the floor. And remember to zip up the front, so pubic bone to navel, sternum to navel. Relax your neck. Keep a gentle hug towards the midline. Shins in. Another breath. Gently your pubic bone. And take an inhale. moving it from side to side. You can move it from side to side. And press back into down dog. Stretching your hands forward, heels back. Bend your knees a little or a lot if you choose. And then lift your sit bones towards the sky. Keeping that, move your thigh bones back and reach your heels towards the earth. Just lifting your arm up, so lifting the arm instead of your arm away from the floor. And move your heart more towards your knees. Press down your thumb and the knuckle of your index finger. Firm your forearms to the midline, firm your shins to the midline. Shares in the body. I should say Kit and Gemma. And then bring your knees to the floor, take rest in child pose or any other pose or foods for your body. You can use your hands to support your head again or stack your fist on your forearms. If you have a little bit more height, it's easier for your hips to descend. Underneath your shoulders, press yourself up and become into a seated wide-legged pose. Flexing your feet. You want to have a bend in your knees. Take your hands behind your hips. Push the floor away so you can lift your hips and stick your bum back and land in front of your sit bones. Keep curling the toes to your shins. And then draw the belly before then stretching to your legs, outstretching your hips. Sit nice and tall. First option to stay. Second option to go into a forward fold. So inhale, lift your spine. Exhale, you choose if you want to go into a gentle forward bend. Keeping your feet vertical. Inhale, lengthen your spine. Anchor the top of your thigh bones. And maybe go into a deeper forward fold. Or stay where you are. Pressing your knees gently down and back, keeping softness behind your knees. And keep anchoring the tops of your thigh bones. The heart is heavy. Soften your gaze and close your eyes. Lengthening your spine, option to stay or hold onto your legs, your shins or ankles. Inhale, lift your spine. Exhale, come into your forward bend. Keeping your feet active. And also keep your belly active, so keep drawing the navel towards your spine. From the core of your belly, keep stretching your knees away from each other. Shoulder and then keep lifting your chest. So the tendency is that the knee collapses in. So move it away, lift your heart. is to lift the hips, moving the hips back so it's easier to release the knee. And then you've got the right distance already to switch legs. So cross left ankle over right knee. You choose again, staying here to make it more, a little bit more intense. Bring your hips forward. Think about moving the left knee forward, so away from your shoulder, while you roll your shoulders or lifting your chest. Make sure your foot is flexed, your left foot, just to protect the knee in that position. Because it's one roll with arms, you press your elbows down to move your shoulders more under you and already taking your chin out of your chest. That is one way. You also can lower your hands down so your arms are on the floor. You can do that also when you're coming up into bridge pose. So you choose. Now lifting your hips and your spine into your bridge pose, and you can go back into roll with arms. You can move your shoulders more under you. You also can clasp your hands behind your back. Whatever works. Widen your collarbones and just make sure you take your chin out of your chest. So the tip of your nose points to the sky. Hanging your shins towards the midline so your legs step out towards each other. Keep your legs where they are, just in line with them. Pressing your feet into the earth and draw or drag your heels back so you feel your hamstrings engaging. And then lift again your pubic bone to your navel. Stretch your spine long. Press down the outer borders of your shoulders. Take another breath. When you come down, when you lower down, if you can place your hands underneath your hips, you're sitting on your hands. Go into a modified elevated leg pulse. So bringing your knees into your chest. And then extend your legs to whatever level, so they can stay completely bent, they can be completely straight. When I say completely straight, I always mean the softness in the knees. And just set your thigh bones into your hip sockets. Bring some softness into your feet and toes. If you prefer to have your hands on either side of your body, you can change it. So feel free to adjust to your body. We can choose to stay for a little bit longer. make your way into Savasana. So just tune in, what do you feel you need? Savasana will be the pose we begin. So you say extend it out in front and separate a little bit wider than hips. If that is uncomfortable, you can keep your knees bent. Press your elbows gently down so you can move your shoulders from under you. Close your eyes. Connect to your breath. Begin the inhale in your lower belly. Move it into your chest and upper chest. Hold it for a bit. And then exhale from your upper chest into your chest, into your lower belly. And continue your own time. Close, and then the head